The focus has been on coastal communities, but the tiny town of Collinsville, an hour west of Bowen, took a direct hit from Tropical Cyclone Debbie. Julita Brand was in her bedroom just before she made the life-saving decision to move to the lounge room, as Debbie claimed parts of her roof.
I heard that very loud bang. If I did not, maybe I am already dead today. I'm lucky. Maybe it's not my time yet.
She rode out the storm, terrified and alone. Her husband recently passed away.
I'm scared last night because it's too windy and it's really heavy. And this is the first time that it happened, it blew everything in the window.
At Collinsville's Food Works, it was a mess. The roof ripped off in the carnage. The rain was free to come flooding in.
Water up to our ankles.
And what did you think when you first saw it?
It was going to take a lot of work to get the business back running again.
It's the only place in the town that can usually open when the power is out, but not now.
Trying to save what we can.
Yeah,
really
I'm sending people away all the time. They want smokes most of the time.
It could be up to a month before this grocery store is able to reopen, but there is a real sense of community here in Collinsville. They've had locals dropping in all day and volunteering to clean up. Phones are completely down in the entire town. The hardware store offering a lifeline. Anyone could use their satellite phone for free, the only way for locals to tell loved ones they had survived.
Just offering what we can do to try and help everyone.
The pub that was being renovated into a backpacker's copped a beating too. Homes and yards in this tiny town in ruins.
Been here for my life and it was really loud, you know, and it was very scary.
In Collinsville, Tessa Hardy, Nine News.